Hey, what's up, guys? It's Darkroom Duels, and today doing some more Factor Drytron test hands. So I'm really excited for you guys because this is actually suggested to me by one of my patrons, Tyler. And this deck is an amazing deck that can actually skip your opponent's turn, which is really amazing with this crazy awesome looking boss monster, the Amor Factor, and using a card called Terminal World. So without further ado, guys, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell there so you can become part of Notification Squad, and definitely check out the Patreon down in the description below for all those awesome rewards, like getting your name through every single video, getting a signed card to mail, and even getting to request a deck profile every single month you're a patron, along with test hands. And definitely give Tyler some love down in the comments down below for suggesting such an awesome deck. So let's get straight on into this one. So this deck is a really interesting deck that revolves around using the Drytrons to get to that really crazy awesome looking boss monster to basically skip your opponent's entire turn. And even if you don't skip your opponent's entire turn, it still skips the main phase and locks down Fusion, Synchro, and XZ monsters, which is really amazing. I love that card when it comes to your side of the field because it could just shut down an opponent's entire turn, which is just so cool. And it's such a powerful boss monster in Drytron. So you guys know it's dad rule number one. We got to pile shuffle up the deck because you don't want to brick. And after we pile shuffle the deck, we're going to give the deck a quick little shuffle and see what we can do because this deck does some crazy awesome plays. So now that we've got the deck shuffled up, let's go ahead and give the deck a quick shuffle and see what we can pull off, because this deck, again, does some really, really crazy stuff. I even teched in Blue Eyes, Chaos Max in the deck to give you another boss monster, so you can basically go in for all sorts of really cool plays. So let's go ahead and see what we can do. So we're going to go ahead and draw into a copy of Delta, Zeta, Blue Eyes White Dragon, Nova, and a copy of Blue Eyes Chaos Dragon. This is not a bad hand. You're not going to be able to skip your opponent's entire turn. If any one of these cards would have been Terminal World in our hand, then we could have skipped the opponent's turn. But we still have some really good plays because we can draw a card. So we might be able to draw into it. So we're going to go ahead and activate that copy of Nova to be able to get from the deck to our side of the field a copy of Alpha Thuban. Alpha Thuban is going to help us out a lot because getting that monster on our side of the field is going to get all of our Drytron plays rolling. So at this point, we're going to go ahead and tag in for the copy of Zeta by tributing it off and then search from the deck a copy of a ritual spell, which is going to be our copy of Advanced Ritual Art. So once we get that copy of Advanced Ritual Art, we're going to go ahead and activate another copy of the Alpha Thuban to be able to tribute it off. And then once we do, we're going to be able to search out our ritual monster, which is going to be our copy of the big boss monster, because once we get that to our hand, it's going to be able to go in for all sorts of different plays with the Amor Factor. Go ahead and activate the copy of the Advanced Ritual Art, which is going to send from the deck to the graveyard a level 8, which is going to be the normal Blue Eyes White Dragon that you're always going to send because you have to send a normal monster for the effect of the Advanced Ritual Art and summon out the Amor Factor. Now, once we summon that monster to our side of the field, we can then go ahead and tribute off the copy of the Alpha Thuban to summon out the Delta. And Delta has a really interesting effect that basically has the ability that when this card is summoned to your side of the field, then you can reveal a ritual monster or ritual spell in your hand and then draw a card, which is really good because we actually have the Blue Eyes Chaos Dragon. So let's give the deck a quick shuffle and hope for the best in what we draw, because if we do draw into a Terminal World, we will completely skip the opponent's turn. If we don't, that's still okay because we're locking them down with Fusion, Synchro, and XZ monsters, which is really, really cool. So now that we've got the deck shuffled up, we're going to go ahead and draw, and hopefully, I don't know what it's going to be, let's see, it's a copy of Chaos Max, but that's okay because next turn we can actually go in for a Chaos Max. So we can pass over to the opponent, and when we pass, this card is very, very unique because what this card does, if you guys are unfamiliar with this card, basically what it does is you can ritual summon this card with its respective ritual spell, which is actually a field spell, which is really weird. And if this card is ritual summoned, your opponent skips their next main phase one, and you negate the effects of all face up Synchro, Fusion, and XZ monsters while they're on the field. And if this card is sent to the graveyard, you can add a Drek Overlord monster from your deck to your hand, which is pretty good to be able to get that search. This card is insanely good because now that we started to roll, we're going to definitely keep our copy of Delta. Our opponent's going to pass back over to us, and we're going to draw for a copy of Cyber Emergency that we can immediately drop against the opponent to be able to search another copy of a card. There was Terminal World, it was on the bottom. So we're going to go ahead and add from deck to hand a copy of Gamma, shuffle up the deck, and then once you do, you have some really, really good plays that we can start rolling into, because now we can actually summon out the copy of, let's say, I don't want to summon the Gamma. Let's go ahead and tag this out and summon out the copy of our Alpha Thuban, because we're just going to go ahead and roll through them. Keep in mind that your Xyz monsters will be locked down, so you won't need to summon out the Mu Beta Fafnir to get a search. So, once we summon out the copy of Alpha, we're going to go ahead and search the deck for another ritual monster, which is going to be another copy of our Amorphage. Now, once we summon out that card to our, once we add that card to the hand, we're going to go ahead and contact out again to be able to tribute, summon this card, and summon your Zeta, which is going to get us a search for a ritual spell. Now, we've used Zeta and Alpha. We haven't used Delta or Gamma, so let's go ahead and use the effect of our Gamma, which is going to be really helpful, or not Gamma, our copy of Delta, because then we're going to get a draw, which could be, again, this time, another copy of our Terminal. We get another chance to be able to grab that card from the deck, so we're going to give it a good shuffle and see what we can get. So let's see what we can actually pull off, and hopefully we're going to reveal any of our three ritual monsters we're going to draw, and it's going to be a copy of Fafnir, which we're going to activate the copy of Fafnir to be able to get an additional search from the deck of a Drytron Nova, which we're then going to shuffle up the deck, and once we shuffle up the deck, we're going to have that card in the hand. Now, at this point, you can use the copy of the Advanced Ritual Art to summon out this card to your side of the field by sending a Blue Eyes White Dragon from the deck to the graveyard, which you could have improved your odds a little bit with the copy of Delta if you would have summoned it out first, but it is going to lock down the opponent again for another turn. You can use the copy of our Delta in the hand to be able to summon out the copy, or use the Delta on the field, summon the Gamma from the hand, which is then going to special summon another Drytron back to the field, which is going to be our copy of Delta, which then can be used as a link material to link summon out an additional monster from the extra deck. Maybe a copy of our IP Mascarena, maybe Cross Sheep, whatever you need. This card has pretty much got you. I usually like to go for Cross Sheep if I don't have game, because it will let me draw two and discard a card, which is pretty helpful. Or you can just leave your monsters on your field like this and tag out next turn for more plays. Now we can attack with these two monsters, and if we go into turn five now, technically turn three because we skipped two turns, we're gonna go ahead and draw into a copy of our Chaos Max, which is pretty good. And then at this point, you can basically just go in for game if your opponent doesn't have anything, but they will get their main phase two, which is kind of interesting about this deck. If you do skip the main phase one, it is really, really good because you have all those really awesome plays that you can do by just summoning out that card. And even if all you do is leave it on the field and you don't summon the second one and you summon a Chaos Max, it will shut down fusion monsters, it will shut down synchros, and even take out your opponent's Xyz, which is really cool. But it's a two-way streak with that card. You're going to actually turn off yours, so keep that in mind as you play this deck. So we're going to go ahead and shuffle up the deck and see what we can pull off for another test hand. So let's go ahead and see what we can pull off. So we're going to go ahead and draw into a copy of Cyber Emergency, Advanced Ritual Art, trade in Terminal World this time, and a copy of our Alpha Thuban. So we actually have full combo this time, so let me show you guys exactly what we do. So we're going to go ahead and activate the copy of Cyber Emergency to grab from the deck a copy of Zeta. Zeta is going to be one of the most important cards that we're going to grab because it's going to be able to tag out for the copy of Alpha Thuban. So we're going to go ahead and send that to the graveyard. And once we do, you can establish a complete lock against your opponent, which is going to be activating the Terminal World. Once you go ahead and activate that card, you're going to be able to tribute the Zeta to be able to summon out the Alpha Thuban, and then you'll be able to add your copy of your Drac Overlord from your deck to your hand. Now, once we add that card to hand, you can then use the effect of the Zeta to put it back on your side of the field, and then you'll be able to add a ritual spell from your deck to your hand, which is the Advanced Ritual Art. You can then shuffle up the deck and then summon out to your side of the field using Advanced Ritual Art. You're going to use one of your two Advanced Ritual Arts to send a Blue Eyes White Dragon to the graveyard and then summon out the copy of the Amorphactor. Now, once you summon out that card to your side of the field, this is going to skip your opponent's main phase one. This is going to skip the main phase two. So the really interesting thing about this is there's six phases in a single turn, which is draw, standby phase, main phase one, battle phase, main phase two, and end phase. Since you're skipping the main phase one, they don't go battle. Since you're skipping the main phase two, they go directly to end phase. So they go draw, standby, end phase. So they don't even get to summon, they just get to draw a card, and then that's it. So once we go into the next turn, the really crazy thing about the Drytrons is you can keep tagging them out every turn. So we're going to draw into a copy of Meteonis, and then this time we're going to use the effects again during our turn to be able to tag them out again to be able to go into our copy of Alpha Thuban, which is going to search from the deck a copy of the dried or the copy of the Amor Factor, and then we're going to tag out again to be able to go for another copy of Advanced Ritual Art, just to make our opponent think we don't already have one in our hand. You can then use the copy of the Advanced Ritual Art again to send an additional copy of Blue Eyes White Dragon from your deck to the graveyard, and then once you do, shuffle up the deck, because that's going to be all the searching we're actually going to be doing in this particular hand. So once we shuffle up the deck, we're going to special summon out to our side of the field the copy of the Amor Factor. Go ahead and fix that graveyard up, want to work clean. And then once you do, you have some really interesting plays that you can actually go into, because you can basically just attack directly with both of these monsters, and then they pass again. So they're not going to get another turn. We actually knocked the top card off. So we're going to go ahead and add a copy of Blue Eyes Chaos Max, but at this point it doesn't matter because you're just going to attack again and it's going to be game. So let's go ahead and see what we can do for the next one. If we would have gotten the Blue Eyes Chaos Max draw, we would have gone 1 and 2, and we could have gone in for a Blue Eyes alternative, because we could have added a Blue Eyes White Dragon and an alternative to the hand, and then also summoned out Chaos Max to get a really crazy feel. So let's go ahead and see what we can do for the next one, because as you guys can see, this deck is all in. This deck is crazy. It's fun. It's really crazy, all the stuff that you can do to be able to just summon out that Amor Factor to your side of the field and go in for all those really good plays. So now that we got the deck shuffled up again, let's see what we can actually pull off. So we're going to go ahead and draw, and we're going to draw into a copy of Advanced Ritual Art. Again, really good. Zeta, a copy of Advanced Ritual Art, a copy of Zeta, and a copy of Fafnir. So this is pretty good. You can actually go a little bit different of a route if you want to this time. If you do go second, however, in this deck can go second, which I'm going to show you guys exactly what you do with that. So the reason I've included Blue Eyes Chaos Max is because you can basically OTK the opponent with three cards. So what we're going to do is activate the copy of Fafnir. Well, technically two once you get them on the field. We're going to go ahead and activate the copy of Fafnir, and we're going to search from the deck a copy of Nova, because Fafnir, when it's activated, lets you add a Drytron spell from your deck to your hand. We're going to activate the copy of the Drytron spell to be able to special summon to our side of the field the Alpha Thuban, and then we're going to start tagging them out. We're going to go ahead and special summon out the copy of our Zeta. And then once you summon out the Zeta, you can add Chaos Max. And then once you add the Chaos Max, you can then tag him out again to be able to summon out the copy of the, basically it'll be reversed, excuse me. This will be actually on the bottom. And we're going to actually summon out the Zeta first, which will search our ritual spell. And once we search out the ritual spell, we're going to be able to add a copy of Chaos Form from our deck to our hand, then tag them out for the Alpha Thuban to be able to add the copy of the Chaos Max. Basically, as long as you have these two rolling, you'll always get a ritual spell and a ritual monster. It didn't really matter. We're going to get them both anyways. So we're going to go ahead at this point and activate the copy of the Advanced Ritual Art, sending from our deck to the graveyard Blue Eyes White Dragon to summon out our copy of Blue Eyes Chaos Max to our side of the field, which is pretty good. To be able to just get that monster on our side of the field, the copy of the Alpha Thuban would still be on the field because we're going to not be tributing it again. So you have the Chaos Max that can then swing. If you want to link this away, you can link it away for a copy of a Link Reboot, just in case you need it, because the only way this card is going to be gone is if they attack through it, because it's really hard to deal with. But then once you go into the next turn, you're going to go ahead and draw to a copy of Blue Eyes Chaos Dragon, activate the Chaos Dragon, or activate the Chaos Form, banish from the graveyard a copy of Blue Eyes White Dragon, and summon this, swing with this, switch something to defense position and drop it to zero, and then swing for game. So you have this really, really good setup with that card. So let's go ahead and see what we can do for another test hand, because this deck is just so good. Just keep in mind that you will always be left with like one Drytron on the field, because basically what you're doing is every single turn with these two, if you have one on the field, you tag it out for the other one, you get the search, you tag it out for the other one. It doesn't matter which one's in the grave. As long as you have one on the field, you're going to be able to tag one out for the other's effect. So you basically just constantly are rolling these two monsters over and over again to be able to get those searches, which is really neat, especially when you skip your opponent's main phase one. So let's go ahead and shuffle up the deck again and see what we can pull off for another test hand. Because as you guys can see, deck is very consistent in what it's trying to do. You could have summoned the Amor Factor if you want to summon that to your side of the field, which would be a pretty good play, but summoning out Chaos Max is always a good play. So let's go ahead and shuffle up the deck and see what we can do for another test hand, because this deck is just ridiculously fun to play with and really, really crazy in what it can actually do. So now that we've got the deck shuffled up, let's go ahead and give it a little quick more shuffle, because we don't know what that card is. Now we got the deck good and shuffled up, we're going to go ahead and see what we can do. So we're going to go ahead and draw into a copy of our Delta, a copy of Chaos Dragon, trade in Cyber Emergency, and a copy of Gamma. So this is not terrible to be able to pull off, because now we have the copy of our Cyber Emergency, which is going to be able to add our copy of Alpha Thuban from our deck to our hand. Or you can get your copy of Zeta. Zeta would be a pretty safe bet to be able to go into instead, because you've already got your Chaos Monster in your hand. Or you could just go ahead and add the copy of Alpha Thuban. Totally up to you which one you actually are going to add. Because you can send the one that you don't have to the graveyard, so you can just add the copy of your Zeta to the hand. So let's go ahead and start tagging them in and out. So what we're going to do is we're just going to immediately tribute off the copy of the Zeta to summon out the copy, or the copy of Delta to summon Zeta. Zeta is going to give us a search of a ritual spell, which is going to be our advanced ritual art, which is going to be pretty good to actually add that card from our deck to our hand. So at this point, you're going to go ahead and tag out the copy of Delta for the copy of Zeta. And once you do, you can reveal this in your hand to be able to draw a card, which is going to be Chaos Form, which is pretty good. Now, at this point, you can go ahead and tag him out again to summon out your copy of Gamma to your side of the field. And once you summon out Gamma, you'll bring back the copy of Delta or Zeta and then overlay both of these cards on your side of the field for Mu Beta Fafnir. Now, Mu Beta Fafnir is really neat in this sort of situation, because what this card does is if this card is Xyz summoned, you can send a Drytron card from your deck to the grave. So usually you would actually send from the deck to the grave Meteonis, but in this situation, I want another ritual monster. So I'm actually going to send from my deck to the graveyard a copy of Alpha Thuban, because I can tribute off the copy of my Alpha Thuban, or I can tribute off the Mu Beta Fafnir to be able to summon out the Alpha Thuban to my side of the field to get all those monsters unlocked all over again and summon him to my side of the field, which is really nice and a really good play. Because now at this point you have that copy of the Alpha Thuban on your side of the field, and you have a search that you're going to be getting off of it, which can be from the deck your copy of Chaos Max, which if you're going second, you can then summon out both of them right here with both of these cards to be able to go in for an OTK, sending a Blue Eyes and setting up the Chaos Form while also summoning out both of these monsters to your side of the field off of these two ritual spells and a single copy of Blue Eyes White Dragon. Because you'll first summon it this way with these two, summon out the Chaos Dragon, and then you'll banish this from the graveyard to be able to go into the copy of the Chaos Dragon. Chaos Max will already be on the field, which is going to get you that full setup, which is pretty good for this particular lineup. Now, however, if you didn't do it a little bit differently and you wanted to see if you could actually dig for some more cards, you could use that copy of trade-in. It's a little risky, but you could. So let's go ahead and just show you guys what would happen if you did discard for that copy of trade-in. So we're going to go ahead and shuffle up the deck. And we're going to go ahead and draw two, discarding off this. And you're only going to draw into another trade-in and another Alpha Thuban. But if we discard our other ritual spell, we're going to draw into a copy of Cyber Emergency and Alternative, which doesn't pay off. Which at this point, you can basically just pass. You can pass against the opponent if you're going second and just go ahead and let him go, because you're going to get this really crazy field. So at this point, you can go ahead during the following turn, you can use that copy of Advanced Ritual Art. So at this point, we're going to go ahead and pass back to us. Say they board wiped us and hit that copy of Alpha Thuban and went to the graveyard. Again, work kind of clean. We're going to go ahead and clean up that graveyard. And once we do, we're going to go ahead and activate the copy of Advanced Ritual Art and then send from our deck to the graveyard a Blue Eyes White Dragon to be able to summon out a copy of Chaos Max, which is pretty good to immediately get that copy of Chaos Max. Now, once we go ahead and activate the copy of Advanced Ritual Art, you can then use your copy of the Drytron Nova to help you thin the deck just a little bit by summoning out the Drytron that you want, like a copy of Alpha Thuban, Gamma, any of the ones that you want, you can just summon to your side of the field. I'm going to summon Alpha Thuban to my side of the field because I'm going to roll all the ones that are in the graveyard, which we actually have all four of them in the grave. So we're going to go ahead and tag out for a copy of Zeta to give us a ritual spell search, which is going to be another copy of Advanced Ritual Art, which is the best ritual spell in this deck and one of the best ritual spells in the entire game. Search out that card from the deck. And once we search out that card, we're going to go ahead and shuffle up the deck. And then you can tag out for the copy of the Alpha Thuban that you didn't use its effect yet to be able to search your copy of your Amor Factor, which is going to be pretty good to search that card because now we have the effect of the trade in to be able to discard the Chaos Dragon to get us a draw. So we're going to go ahead and shuffle up the deck. And once we shuffle up the deck, we're going to hope for the best because we're going to get a draw 3, which is going to be pretty helpful. So at this point, go ahead and tag into the Delta. Reveal the copy of the Amor Factor that they already know is there, which is going to give us an additional draw. So once we're going to go ahead and draw one card, which is going to be a copy of our Nova, which is not going to help us too much, but at this point, you can use the copy of the trade-in, or just to guarantee that you're not going to get a copy of Blue Eyes, you can go ahead and send the Blue Eyes from the deck to be able to ritual summon either of the monsters that you want between these two, depending on what the situation is. This is turn 3 technically, so we're going to go ahead and summon out either this or this, depending on if you know you can OTK, you summon out the Chaos Dragon. If you want to skip the next turn and they have a full field of like Xyz or anything like that, you can summon out your copy of your Amorphage. So at this point, we're going to go ahead and discard the copy of the Chaos Dragon, shuffle up the deck, and see what we can do. Because if we do draw into that copy of Terminal World at this point, because the deck is getting awfully thin, we will be able to go in for plays by the copy of Trade-In that we're discarding the Chaos Dragon that's in the graveyard. We're discarding that card from the hand and ritual summoning out this. We're going to draw 2 cards, which is not going to be the copy of Terminal World, which is the only downside to this deck, is sometimes you just don't draw into it. But this card on its own is worth the summon, and I'm considering actually leaving it in my Chaos Max deck because I want to tech it into that deck because it's just so crazy good to be able to just summon that card in the field. Let's do one more quick test hand because I'm going to show you guys how easy it is with Terminal World in your hand with exactly what you can do with this deck. So we're going to go ahead and shuffle up the deck. We're going to say that this is already in our hand. If we do draw into another one, we'll just shuffle it back into the deck and draw another card. So let's go ahead and see what we can do. Or actually, let's just do it this way. Let's shuffle up the deck. If we don't draw it, we'll search the deck and make it our 5th card. So we're going to go ahead and shuffle up the deck and see what we can do for the next play, because this card is a very good tech card to be able to play in this deck. So now that we got the deck shuffled up, we're going to draw into a copy of Chaos Dragon, Melody of Awakening Dragon, Cyber Emergency, a copy of Nova, and then at this point, we're going to add the copy of Terminal World to the hand, and we're going to go ahead and go off from here. So we're going to go ahead and activate the copy of Nova. I'm going to show you guys exactly how to skip your opponent's turn again. We're going to activate the copy of Nova, be able to search the deck, special summon out the copy of Alpha Thuban, use the effect of Cyber Emergency to be able to summon or search a data or a delta. So, search that copy of Delta, or not Delta, Zeta. These names, they're all kind of close. So we're going to go ahead and search that card out, tag out for a copy of another monster on your side of the field. You can get a search if you want to right here. Instead, if you want to just search out that copy of Zeta before you tribute off the copy of your Alpha, you can use the copy of Melody, and this card will go to the graveyard, which is totally fine because it's basically for free that you're going to get that search, which is really, really good for this deck to be able to get that copy of Chaos Max and get from the deck another card like your copy of, or you can even go a different route. Instead of searching the Chaos Max, you can search a Blue Eyes, and you can search our one of alternative in the deck to be able to special summon that monster out to the field just to give you a little bit more damage later on. So at this point, now you can tag out your copy of your Zeta for Alpha, and it's going to be able to then get you a search from the deck of a ritual spell, and then now that you've tagged out that, you're going to get that one tag out for the search of, where is it, the Amor Factor. So now that we've gotten our double search, these are the two searches that we got off those two monsters, you're going to activate the copy of the Advanced Ritual Art to be able to send from the deck to the graveyard that copy of Blue Eyes White Dragon, shuffle up the deck, and summon out the copy of the Amor Factor, activate Terminal World, reveal the Blue Eyes in the hand to summon out the Chaos Dragon, or not the Chaos Dragon, but alternative, and then pass against the opponent where they can't even go into their turn, draw into the next turn, and then you can discard the Blue Eyes for a draw if you do want it, to be able to go in for 2 more cards. And then you can start tagging them out again to be able to tag out the Alpha all over again, just like we did last turn. Tag out Alpha for Zeta. Zeta will give us a search of a ritual spell, which can be the Chaos form. And then you're going to tag out the Zeta for the Alpha, which is pretty good. Tag out Zeta for Alpha, search Chaos Max, drop the copy of Chaos form, banish a Blue Eyes, summon out the Chaos Max, and go in for game, because now you have all these monsters on your field. You can use the copy of the Nova if you want to special summon out a Drytron from the deck. It's not going to be super helpful to be able to tag out in and out to be able to draw a card, because even if we summoned out the Delta to our field and got a draw, it would be okay, but it wouldn't help us out because we've already got pretty much game. So I think that's gonna do it for this one, guys, because this deck is just super, super good to play with. I really love playing the Amor Factor in this deck, because being able to just play that card and play Chaos Max right next to it is just super cool. I'm really glad that Tyler actually suggested this deck, because this deck is wild. Being able to summon out that copy of the Amor Factor plus Terminal World is just such a crazy combo. Just skip your opponent's turn, and then being able to re-ritual summon this card out, and being able to just use, being able to use the copy of Alpha Thuban and your copy of Zeta, just going like switching them up and searching these two cards, or searching out the copy of the Amor Factor and your ritual spell, is just so good, because basically as long as you have one of these on the field and you're tagging them out every single turn, you're going to be able to then basically search every single turn these two cards, which is really cool to be able to just skip your opponent's main phase one every single turn. So I think that's going to do it for this one, guys. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. If you guys would like to check out the deck profile, it is always down in the description down below for every test hand videos. And don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Hit the bell on there so you can become part of the notification squad. And we'll see you guys in the next video. See you later, guys.